My name is Dave Wilhelm. I am an associate professor in the Business Administration Department at Wake Technical Community College in Raleigh, North Carolina. I teach seated and online classes. This video is one in a series that tries to ensure that my online students get almost as much information as my seated students. This particular information is a response to some students who, in discussing using PERT charts, the pictorial diagrammatic method, why can't we just do it in Excel? And it turns out you can do it in Excel, and this video shows how to do that. If you're not familiar with PERT, there is a PERT in Gantt video in the Dave Wilhelm NC channel on YouTube that may get you in the right ballpark. So let's talk about how to do PERT in Excel.
This video covers using Excel spreadsheets exclusively rather than pictorial representations to determine a project's cumulative elapsed time, its critical path, and its critical task. Here's a typical PERT table representation of a project. Across the top, the column identifiers are the task identity, the tasks on which each task depends on, in other words, the ones that have to be done previously, and the execution time of each task, T exec. The row identifiers down the left are the tasks of the project under the task column heading. The other two columns are the task's dependencies, which will be one or more other tasks, and each task's execution time. In this case, there are 10 tasks, A through J. The project starts with task A, which has no dependencies, and the project is complete when task J is finished. The execution times could be any time units, call them days if you'd like something to call them. Here is a typical pictorial PERT representation to determine the cumulative elapsed time, the critical path, and the critical task. The first step in this representation is to determine the topography and then simply transfer from the table to the diagram the task IDs, their execution times, and the task dependencies as are indicated by the arrows. Then, going from left to right, calculate the elapsed times after each task. And we see that the total cumulative elapsed time for this example is 27 days. To determine the cumulative elapsed time in an Excel table representation, we add two columns, T start and T end, which are the start and end times for each of the tasks. A useful simplification that can be made when doing the PERT calculations simply in Excel is to identify the start and end tasks. In particular, have a single identified beginning task and a single identified ending task. In this case, our case for this example, task A is the initial task and task J is the final task. Just a reminder, what we should have as we go through the Excel version is this table. And T start of A is 0, end is 3, and on down through task J, where the time start is 23 and the time end is 27. The start time for tasks F and J is where we will get interesting, because tasks A through E have a single task dependency, whereas F through J have multiple task dependencies before they can start. Now, to determine those values using just the PERT chart rather than the diagrams, the first task is simple. Task A has no dependencies, so it can start immediately at time 0, and we can enter 0 in time start A. For all tasks, the ending time is equal to the starting time plus the execution. And so in the time end cell for task A, we enter T end equal T start plus TX, which will be equal to 0 plus 3. And be sure to enter the formula, not the value in that cell. But what we should see is time end for A equals 3. Next, determine the T start and T end times for task B. From the dependency column, we see that task B depends only on task A. So the time of start B is equal to the time of end A, or 3 days. And in that cell, we should enter equals time end A, not 3, but 3 will show up. The task B end time is simply equal to its start time plus its execution time. We enter that formula into the cell, and what shows up is 7. And that's still correct if you want to go back and check the pictorial version. The next three tasks, tasks C, D, and E, are similarly determined. Each task has a single dependency, so time start C equals time end A, time start D equals time end A, and time start E equals time end B. The values for C are start at 3, end at 8. For task D, start at 3, end at 9. For task E, start at time 7 and end at time 15. Now it's going to get interesting, because task F has two dependencies, task B and C. Both must be finished before task F can start. So time start F equals the maximum of those two dependency end times, max of TNB and TNC. We enter that formula in the T start column for task F, and that turns out to be 8. And if we go back and double check, sure enough, time in C is greater than time in B, and time in C is 8. So that's what we see, and that's what we should see. The time end F is just its execution time plus the start time. And for the rest of the tasks, G through J, the same type of formula applies. The time start for any of those tasks is the maximum of the time ends of their dependent tasks. If you're unfamiliar with the Excel function, especially max, you can find information on those in Excel under the functions information tab. And time in J is the cumulative elapsed time for the entire project. Well, we've got it. So what? Well, One actual advantage over the Excel spreadsheet version of PERT charting is that we can change the execution times of any of the tasks, and they will automatically roll through the rest of the formulas to show us what has changed. In this case, if we change the execution time of task C from 5 to 7, the end time of task C will change, plus all the start and end times of tasks F through J, and the total cumulative elapsed time will now be 28. The next step is to determine the critical path. Unfortunately, there's no way to do this automatically as we did with the cumulative elapsed time, but neither is it that bad. Task J is on the critical path. There are no parallel tasks. It is the final task. So J is on the critical path. What delays task J? Well, we see its dependencies are tasks H and I. Task H ends at 21. Task I ends at 23. So task I is the one on the critical path. Task I's task dependencies are F and G. Task G, time end is 16. Time F, time end is 14. So task G is also on the critical path. Task G's dependencies are C and D. Time end C is 8. Time end D is 9. So task D is also on the critical path. Task D is dependent only on A, so A is also on the critical path. So our critical path is A, D, G, I, J. And if we click back to the pictorial version, it agrees. So that's always a bit of a relief when something new agrees with something we have done previously. The critical task is also manual. In this case, we look at the execution times of the tasks that are on the critical path. In this case, task E has the longest execution time, but since it's not on the critical path, it's not the critical task. In this case, tasks G and I are both on the critical path and they have the highest execution time of the tasks on the critical path. So in this case, we have two critical tasks, task G and task I.
That's it for our discussion about how to solve PERT problems in Excel rather than in a diagram. I hope this proved either interesting or useful. Both would be nice. If you have questions or comments, just send me an email, and in the subject line, please put PERT in Excel.